What's up, everybody? My name is Alex. I'm going to be making a traditional Greek street food. It's a gyro with souvlaki and tzatziki. I chose Greece because I really like the culture and I love eating Greek food, and I have yet to make it myself, so I wanted to just try it out, give it a go. Yeah, I'm stoked on the Mediterranean diet, and making some street food sounds interesting and exciting. I didn't want to make something too difficult, and I wanted to make something that, you know, everybody can make just during the week, and this seems like a really super, seems like a great recipe. Alright, hope you guys enjoy. Okay, so to start, we're going to make the souvlaki, and the recipe calls for a pork tenderloin, and so we pick one of these up, and it says to chop it into small strips, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. You want to keep them pretty even strips so they cook at the same time. I like to cook my pork on the bone, but this time we're doing it the traditional Greek way. I guess I'm just going to chop it off the bone first. I don't like to waste any food, so we'll give the dog the scraps, make her happy. Definitely leave the fat on because that adds a lot of flavor. We got lucky, this one only has a little bit of bone in there. Definitely have a sharp knife because a dull blade, you don't know what it's going to do, but a sharp knife, you know exactly how it's going to cut every time. All right, so we got our pork cut into thin strips. We're going to put it right over here in the mixing bowl. Now we're going to add the rest of the ingredients for the marinade. I'm going to start off with one clove of garlic. My girlfriend and I went to Santa Clara Art and Wine Fest, and we picked this little garlic de-sheller. Came with a little... came with this sweet thing and also a little ceramic dish that you could actually scrape the garlic that way. But this recipe calls for sliced garlic, so I'm gonna follow the recipe. So this is all ingredients that are going to go into the mixing bowl with the pork chop, and it's gonna become a marinade that we're going to let sit overnight. Recipe says preferably let it sit overnight. You could also do just for an hour or two, or not at all, honestly. But if you're doing pork, you definitely want to marinate it because it's pretty, the meat is on the tougher side. And when you're doing garlic, you really want to press out all those essential oils. So chopping it up a little bit and then pressing out. I learned that one from Jacques Pepin. Okay, so there we go. Got the garlic.
into the bowl. All right, so the marinade calls for 1 clove of garlic, also a half of half an onion, and an onion. Best way to cut this. I like minced onion, but this recipe calls for strips. So again, we're gonna do what the recipe calls for. And this definitely sounds like a really tasty dish. All right, so you cut the ends off, cut it into strips. And my eyes are already burning. I'm blowing slightly on the onion just to get the nastiness away, but sometimes I'll wear swim goggles or anything really, just to keep the onion away. All right, so there's some nice strips. That'll break down in the marinade and also in the pan when we're frying it up. Okay, we got the garlic, we got the half, we got the 1 clove of garlic, the half red onion.
So now we're gonna add 3 tablespoons olive oil. Normally I'd use a little mini rubber spatula, but I couldn't find that. 2 tablespoons red wine vinegar. Tablespoon of oregano. And a pinch of rosemary. That smells good. Fresh from the garden. Then we got the half tablespoon of honey, which is gonna be a pain to get in there because it's cold. Sweet. So now we got all the ingredients for the marinade. Now we're gonna let that marinade sit overnight. Or if you're, you know, you're making a lunchtime snack, you can let it sit in the refrigerator for an hour or two and you should be good to go. Yeah, I'd recommend either using a squeeze bottle for the honey, not using the fancy cooking show style of putting everything in little bowls. All right, now for the fun part. We get to mix with your hands. Recipe says mix with your hands so you can really marry all the flavors together. And don't be shy, kind of really dance it around there. It's starting to smell really good. Sounds a little weird, but it's gonna be delicious when we're cooking it up in the pan. All right, so now while the souvlaki is marinating, is the perfect time to put together the tzatziki, the cucumber yogurt dip. And for that, we're gonna use 1/4 cup olive oil, 2 tablespoons red wine vinegar, 500 grams of Greek yogurt, Greek for sure, 1 clove of garlic, and 1 cucumber. All right, so I got a waxed cucumber, so I'm gonna peel it. In some instances, you can get a cucumber that you don't need to peel, which is preferable, because that's where most of the nutrients and a lot of the flavor is. But this will do just fine. Some people peel towards themselves, I peel away. Just like in a fast car. All right, cucumbers all peeled, I think. Oh, hello. Tonight, I'm gonna have myself a real good time. I feel alive. The world, I'm turning inside. Alright, so I double checked the recipe and it calls for grated cucumber. But since I already started chopping it, I'm just going to mince it a little bit finer. And then I'm going to squeeze the excess water out of it in this towel before all of the ingredients go into the food processor. Now this classic yogurt and cucumber dish can be found throughout parts of the Mediterranean and the Middle East. So a lot of the Greek cuisine is blended in with Middle Eastern cultures like the Ottoman Empire, because of all the trading that was being done. So you got a lot of traditional dishes that could be considered Greek or Persian, but today we're doing the Greek twist on this classic cucumber yogurt. So I'm going to go over here, squeeze the life out of this cucumber, which honestly I could probably, that's pretty good. Cucumber is pretty good for you. Full of electrolytes and wow, this is a lot of water. I think cucumbers are just pretty much all water. And it just keeps going. Sweet. Alright. So we've got the cucumber squeezed, we've got our olive oil, red wine vinegar. Now we just need to get this garlic. And it says chop it up, but honestly it's going in the food processor anyway, so I'm just gonna get the peel off and that should be fine. All right. So now, I'm sure if you don't have a food processor at home, you could also use a blender, which is what
I might end up doing right now, just because
the food processor that I have takes so long to clean that it's better just to use a blender. Alright, off to the food processor or blender. Alright, so we got the food processor here. I'm going to add the chopped and minced garlic, which was pressed out to get the essential oils out. And then we're going to add the 1/4 cup of olive oil. And then before we add the cucumber and the yogurt and the vinegar, we're just going to blend the garlic with the olive oil just to get all those flavors together. So we got the food processor right here. We're just gonna give the olive oil and the garlic a quick mix. All right, so we got the garlic and the olive oil mixed up. Now we're gonna add the red wine vinegar, the Greek yogurt, calls for 400 grams of Greek yogurt. And also it was 2 tablespoons of red wine vinegar. So we got the yogurt in there. Now we just salt and pepper. I love pepper. That's really good. And then don't waste anything. And the cucumber, which was pressed so the water comes out of it. All right, now let's blend it up. All right, we got the tzatziki all blended. You can see all the delicious ingredients right there. The yogurt, cucumber, salt, pepper, olive oil, red wine, vinegar, all blended together. Actually made more than I expected, so we're gonna be eating a lot more gyros for lunch and dinner. All right, so we've let the souvlaki marinate for 2 hours, and we got our tzatziki, the yogurt sauce, and now we're preheating the oven to 450, so we can heat up and toast our pita breads that we're also gonna drizzle lightly with olive oil before we put them in the oven. It's gonna be really tasty. And right now we're gonna saute the souvlaki.
All right, so now that we got the marinade, 2 hours in the fridge, a little olive oil in the pan, and let's heat this over medium. Here it start to sizzle a bit. Could probably turn it up just a little bit. There we go. All right, now we'll let it cook until the pork's cooked through. I think that's 165 for pork. Don't quote me on that. Check that out. I'm not trying to poison anybody. All right, so I've been cooking it now for about 4 or 5 minutes, stirring every now and again. It smells absolutely amazing. Like the rosemary, the oregano, all those flavors are blending nicely. I'm really stoked to eat this. Just give another minute, make sure the pork's cooked all the way through. And right now I'm gonna go put those, toast the pita pockets in the oven.
All right, so one of the last things I'm gonna do before I plate the dish is slice some tomatoes. Again, with any fruit or vegetable that you don't peel, definitely go for the organic. I think that was week 14 or 15 that we learned about that. But the more you know, the more you want to eat local and grow your own food in a backyard or a community garden and share with neighbors. That's the future. All right, so we got the tomatoes chopped. I got the tzatziki. Now we just got to toast the pita in the oven and should be good to go. Right, now we're putting some olive oil over the pitas before we toast them in the oven. This is that extra special treatment. Normally I'd just throw them in the toaster and call it a day, but going all out for this. Right. Again, it just says 2 minutes at 450 degrees, just to get that nice toast. And then we'll plate it up. All right, so we got everything all laid out. Pitas are nice and toasty. I'm gonna start by putting the tzatziki around there, put that on the bottom. Then we get the souvlaki. Again, it just smells so good. Got a little bit to start. And then salt and pepper the tomatoes. And there. Wrap it up just like that. Mm. All right, here's the toast to this traditional Greek street food, kalioreski. I picked the right country. So if you're thinking about making this for lunch or dinner sometime, and you want to get a guesstimate of what it's going to cost, the pork chops cost about $5, tomatoes, organic, another $2, cucumber, $2, the yogurt was another $2, pita bread was $2.50 for the organic non-GMO. And assuming you have all the other olive oil, the vinegar, salt, pepper, spices, just for the basic ingredient, the red onion as well, it's gonna get, under $15 is about what it's gonna cost. So, you know, typical In-N-Out meal is $20 for two people. So it's a good cost-effective way to do it. It's tasty too. So before I saute the, oh god, a gyro with souvlaki. No, is it?
Souvlaki.
Alright. And oh wait, I shouldn't be looking around. Hang on. Delete that. And oh no. Let's start over.